Insurance Agency and Woodall Agency have great news. Effective January 1st, they have joined forces to provide even more options for all your insurance needs. Together, they provide the best prices and coverage from top-rated insurance companies and insure all lines of insurance. See Tori Hammett or Fred Foltz, or go to insurewithgoodwin.com for more information. Don't pay too much for your insurance. Let them shop for you and save today.
Your local McDonald's wants you to know that they're ready to serve you for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. They've always had their drive-thru, and now they're offering curbside pickup service as well. To avoid the wait in the drive-thru, you can download the McDonald's app and try curbside pickup. They appreciate your patience and understanding during this time. We are all having to adjust to this new way of life. It's temporary, but in the meantime, enjoy breakfast, lunch, or dinner at your local McDonald's.
Caldwell County is a special place in western Kentucky, featuring beautiful tracts of land. Even though the real estate market is always in a constant state of change, Bollinger Real Estate and Auction understands this and is ready to work for you.
Hi, my name is Ben Bollinger with Bollinger Real Estate and Auction. Whether it's a property valuation or time to sell, Bollinger's team is dedicated to work for you. Real estate solutions with a passion for people.
It's time for your SportsEdge.com Sideline Report with Todd Griffin. Talking sports and more here on 1580 103.3 WPKY and worldwide at WPKYonline.com. Here's your host, Todd Griffin.
Good morning, everyone. The Sideline Report is on the air from 1035 West Main Street in Princeton. Hope you're somewhere safe today. If you're out on the roadways, be careful. Roadways are still slick in spots, especially the best advice they give right now is if you don't have to be out, don't. If you're out there and hopefully you're driving four-wheel drive and taking it careful on the roads, and also especially not just on the roadways, but when you get out of the house, be careful on the sidewalks getting to your vehicle and from your vehicle to your place of work. Parking lots are kind of slick too, so just be careful out there if you're out and about today on wintry weather Thursday. We do thank you for joining us here on the Sideline Report, and we're going to hit the ground running this morning. Murray State University pitcher Shane Burns is on the phone with us. And good morning, Shane. Thanks for coming on the show.
Yeah, appreciate it, Todd. Thank you.
Yeah, how are things in Murray this morning?
Pretty much about like it is in Princeton. I walked outside this morning and saw a sheet of ice, and I thought I would stay in. I was going to try to go in town and give me some breakfast and move around a little bit, but I decided that wasn't best for me, so I just stuck here at my house, and that's where I'm at right now.
You said earlier there was still a little precipitation coming down in Murray.
Yeah. I went outside, and it just sounded like little BB pellets hitting me on the back of my shirt and stuff. So I decided it wasn't the best to get out. So I'm sitting here in my house and looking forward to a good show.
Well, the weather doesn't look like it right now, but it is almost baseball season.
Yeah. That's the scary part. You know, we these next few days and maybe a week don't look too good for us. I know this past week, We had some practices that were right at freezing or right below, and we had to take the advantage of it and get outside the best we could and throw bullpens and go live. And these next few days we're going to be inside, unfortunately. Hopefully we can hopefully make practice in the next couple of days if this ice and the weather progresses. But we're just trying to take advantage of every little opportunity we can get, and hopefully be able to open up next Friday night in Nashville.
Yeah, we finally got a schedule last week, and it seemed like it was taking a while, but it looks like a pretty challenging schedule for you guys this year there at Murray State. The season opens with a trip to Lipscomb, and are you guys ready to go?
Yeah, I think everybody's ready to go. I think we returned a lot of guys from last year. We have a lot of depth in the offensive side of things. I think our pitching staff, as long as we can go out there and do damage control and we can go out there and, put up, three or four runs, I think our offense is going to take away. We're never going to be out of a game once our offense gets to the batter's box. I always have the confidence that our guys are going to step up there and put up the runs that are needed for us. And that's something that's always in the back of your mind as a pitcher. Knowing having a good offense is always good, when you're on the mound, that they're going to have your back.
Well, and you guys were playing really well last year or last spring when the COVID hit.
Yeah, we opened up in Southern Miss. I think we lost three games by one run or something like that. And you know, they're a team that, you know, puts conference tournaments back together or every year, season in, year in and year out. We came home against St. Peter's. I'm pretty sure we had a, you know, a four-game sweep, and then we take off to Austin Peay, which is our first conference series, and we win that, and, you know, we win, you know, our first three of our first four series, and we're on a roll. And obviously, unfortunately, with all this pandemic coming in, and, you know, we got shut down early. But granted, you know, we all got our year back, and I think everybody came back, but our Friday night starter, Trevor McMurray, and our catcher, Brian Chilton. So we got a lot of guys returning and took advantage of that redshirt year that the NCAA granted us.
Well, with the number one guy moving on, do you move into that number one pitching spot now?
Yeah, you know, I hope so. You know, I haven't really talked to our coaching staff much about it. You know, me personally, I'm just prepping like I am on Friday nights. And then if anything changes after that, you know, we can move from there. But definitely want that Friday night spot. You know, everybody dreams as a kid playing, you know, this week or this year we go to Arkansas third weekend of the season. And we open up with, you know, Arkansas that Friday night. You know, there's nothing better playing SEC baseball on Friday night and being that Friday night guy. So there's always something that you want to strive for. But yeah, you know, I'm always planning to be that guy, and if something changes, you know, definitely we'll go from there.
Well, kind of cool getting to start the season down in Nashville at Lipscomb. Have you played down there before? Have you got to pitch there before?
I have not. You know, it's actually kind of cool. Coach Crawford, he's their pitching coach there at Lipscomb, and he actually recruited me here at Murray State a few years back when he was here, so it's going to be kind of cool to play against him again. My freshman year, I actually got a chance to play against him. He's a pitching coach at Austin Peay, but it's going to be pretty cool to circle back with him and go and play with him against at Lipscomb.
Well, when you go to each ballpark, are mounds a little different? Do you have to get used to each mound, or is that even something you think about?
Yeah, for sure. You know, when we get there on Thursday nights, our travel day, you know, our pitching staff will get together. You know, a lot of it's scenery. You know, when you go to these bigger stadiums, you know, the scenery can play a big big role on your depth perceptions and stuff like that. You know, we went to Southern Miss, you know, they had a bigger stadium. We had to get out there and just kind of, you know, get our eyes adjusted to, you know, the bigger field, to the bigger stadiums and stuff like that. And that definitely plays a bigger part. And like I said, when we go play these bigger teams this year, when we go play Louisville, Kentucky, and Arkansas, you know, they're going to have bigger stadiums. So it's definitely something you got to take in consideration.
We're talking this morning with Shane Burns, Murray State pitcher, former Caldwell County Tiger, here on the Sideline Show and the Sideline Report. We appreciate everybody tuning in this morning. Shane, you mentioned getting ready to start the season and pitching, and I know you guys have been doing a whole lot of off-season work. What are you kind of hitting now with your fastball?
You know, I'm not too, you know, I know I get this question asked me a lot. You know, my body feels great. From last season, I dropped about 25 to 30 pounds. I'm a lot stronger than I have been. You know, my body's feeling pretty good. I haven't been clocked here too recently, but I can tell you back in the fall that I was hitting anywhere from 90-91. So that's some things, the bright side of things to look forward to and just try to build off of that. But just the main thing, like I said, I can say it till I'm blue in the face. You know, you just got to locate at this level. You can throw 95 miles an hour here, but you're going to get hit around the park if you can't locate it and you don't have good off speed to balance that off. So, you know, the biggest thing for me is I'd rather spot, you know, 87 or 88 on the side of the plate versus 95 right down the middle, because, I mean, it's just going to get turned right back around. You know, these guys are too advanced of hitters to just be worried about velo. And, you know, like I said, I'll say it until my career is here over at Murray State.
Well, I was going to ask about the fastball. Do you think about how hard you're throwing it, or do you have a fastball that you use for the most part? Do you have a little extra that you can use when you especially need it, or what are you thinking out there on the mound?
I mean, yeah, you know, all pitchers, you know, if you have a, you know, 1-2 count, if you have the favor in your account, you know, the coach calls a fastball, you know, you got, you know, not necessarily a pitch to waste, but, you know, you might want to put a little something extra on it, knowing if it's a ball, it ain't going to hurt you. Yeah, and all pitchers do that. You know, sometimes, you know, you kind of get in a groove and you just want to get in, you know, like I said, getting a good groove. But, you know, if you're in a good plus count, you know, there's always times you reach back and, you know, try to put a little more on it. But for the most part, you know, you always try to stay within yourself, because at the same time, you're trying to get this guy out and not mess around with him too much.
Well, I think we've talked about this a little bit before, but what are some of the biggest differences from going from high school and pitching to going to college and pitching?
Yeah, it's always a good question. I know you know, always iterate that to me every time, you know, I'm on the show. You know, just like I said, the guys 1-9 can swing the bat. you know, these guys, you know, once you think you get to the 7, 8, 9 hole, you know, those guys can do just as much damage as the 1, 2, 3 hole. And that's something that'll humble you at this level. In high school, you know, once I got past the, you know, first 3 hitters, maybe the 4th hitter, you know, there wasn't much challenge to that. It's just grew fastballs and get on to the next guy. But at this level, if you don't have 3 pitches you can locate, it's going to be challenging for you. And it'll show, you know, they'll put a crooked number up for you real quick. And, you know, and another biggest difference offset that, you know, the defense here at the next level, you know, they're making plays that high school players wouldn't make. So you can also make that argument at the same time. So in some sense, it balances each other out. But in all reality, you know, this game, even in the OVC level, it's crazy the difference amount from Caldwell County to Murray State, for sure.
Well, do you find that maybe the umpiring is just a little bit different, too? Do you find that the strike zone in college is just a little bit smaller than maybe it was in high school at times?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, there's times you get out there and you feel like you can't hit the broadside of a barn, and, you know, you feel like you're putting the ball in the outside corner, the inside corner, and you can't get that, you know, pitch that's, you know, an inch or two off the plate. You know, sometimes it all depends up to that umpire. But, yeah, it's mostly black to black in college, and they ain't going to go from it. You know, them college guys, you know, them umpires know what they're doing. They've been been doing that for years, and it's tough to get them to expand their zone much. So, you know, once you find out their zone the first 2 or 3 innings, you know, that's what you're working with. So if they don't give you that low and outside pitch, they ain't going to give it to you in the 7th or 8th inning either. So it's just something you got to learn in the second, third inning, and, you know, you got to make do with, for sure.
Well, I don't remember you ever really having a problem with home plate umpires and all the times I've seen you pitching, but obviously no pitcher wants to go out there and have a real tight strike zone where you have to be forced to throw something over the heart of the plate to a hitter.
Right, yeah. And a lot of that, you know, your catcher, you know, depends on what kind of relationship has with the umpire. You know, if your catcher thinks he's getting squeezed, for sure your catcher's got your back on that. And you always got to communicate that when you go back in the dugout. For sure, your catcher's, you know, always your guy that takes care of you with the umpires. And if you have to, you know, it ain't going to do you no good to express how you feel on the mound. So you always got to leave that up to your coaches to, you know, have your back. But for sure, you know, it's always good to have a good relationship with the umpires and to communicate that with them. But for most part, you know, you should leave it to your catchers to communicate, you know, if you're getting squeezed that day or not.
Now, if I counted right, there are 7 former Tigers right now playing college baseball. How much do you keep up with those other guys, and do you guys talk back and forth sometimes about how you're doing?
Yeah, and I keep up with most of the guys I graduated with, obviously Bryce and Jay Shrine and the guys that are still in. You know, it's always cool to, you know, see, you know, we have 7 guys, you know, those 7 guys, you know, my senior year, we was all on the same team. So it's pretty cool to see that all come together. I know Jay Shrine, you know, is still at Ren Lake in his 3rd year. I'm sure he'll get a shot to move up at D1. And Bryce just went to NKU, and I'm sure he'll be a big utility player for them this year. And just looking forward to see what the guy's going. You know, we always dreamed about this when we're 9 or 10 years old, growing up playing, you know, travel baseball together. And it's coming reality. So it's pretty cool to see that, and, you know, I'm thinking we're all taking advantage of our opportunities the best we can.
Yeah, and there's a couple of other guys that could have been playing college baseball maybe, and, you know, you throw another 2 or 3 out there, and now you've got an entire team of former Tigers playing college ball.
Right, yeah. You know, I'll there might be some former Tigers out there that might want to argue in this, but I think, you know, we had the best team come through Caldwell County baseball-wise, and I think it shows right now. You know, like you said, we have, you know, possibly 2 or 3 other guys that can play college baseball, and that puts us right there at 10 guys. And you know, we all work for it. You know, our coaches definitely put us in the position to do that. And, you know, we enjoyed every moment we had, you know, playing in a Tiger uniform. And to be honest, if someone told me I could step back into one, I wouldn't complain. So it's definitely something I cherish, and we all got to take advantage of what we got right now.
Well, you guys certainly had a good run at Caldwell County. What do you maybe miss from your high school playing days?
You know, here in college, these guys, you know, you build chemistry with these guys, but it's nothing like the guys you grew up with. You know, it's from, you know, playing T-ball all the way up to 10U to, you know, winning regional championships with these guys, and that's something you can't take back, and that's something I miss, is being with the guys. And, Coach Dallas, obviously, one of the greatest coaches, you know, we've had at our school history, and just the atmosphere, you know, every night everybody expected us to win, and just having that chip on your shoulder, knowing that you had the talent to be special and going out there and doing it was always great. And going up to Whitaker Bank, you know, for state tournaments was, you know, always something that we weren't always going to cherish. But, you know, like I said, I wouldn't hesitate if someone told me I could step back in a uniform today.
We're talking with Murray State pitcher Shane Burns, a former Caldwell County Tiger this morning. And, Shane, as a pitcher at Murray, you get to pitch, what, like once a week? Do you miss getting to be able to go out there and play every day?
Yeah, we're about once a week. You know, once you get in a rotation, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, or if you're that midweek, whether Tuesday or Wednesday, it's usually one day a week. But there's always those days you miss about going out there for me, you know, going out and play first base or step in the batter's box. But, you know, like I said, Todd, you know, it's so hard at this level that if I was to step in the batter's box and face someone, I wouldn't know what to do. I'd just freeze because I don't know what 90, 92 coming out of the hand looks like. So, I mean, there's days that you want to, but there's days you just got to step back and say, hey, these guys know what they're doing and I need to do my job.
Yeah, so you've never lobbied the coaches at least once to grab a bat and jump in the batter's box?
No, I have, jokingly, but there has been times, you know, after a good series, after a good win, our coaches will let us have pitcher's BP, so that's always pretty cool. The next practice, you know, if the pitchers go out and perform well, he'll give us a few cuts at the next day's practice, but never live. So it's always good to get pitcher's BP, but after that, it's time to get back on the mound and get ready for the next opponent.
Now, we mentioned we've got seven kids from Caldwell County that are playing college baseball right now. Three guys are down there on the Murray State University football roster. Shane, how much do you see those guys, and how are they doing?
Actually, I live with Mitchell Harrelson, and I see Oliver just a little bit, which he just got here this semester, and then Joby. Obviously, I see Mitchell a lot more than I do Oliver or Joby, but definitely keep in touch with them. And as far as I know, everything's going good for them. I think they open up a week from Sunday against SEMO, if I'm not mistaken here. So from everything I hear, you know, everything's going good. Obviously, excited for Oliver to get a new opportunity here at Murray and see what he can do with it. Just obviously looking forward to see what these guys can do at this level at college football. Even though it's Division One, you know, Double A football, these guys are ginormous. You know, I walk in the locker room and I see them. These guys can bring it. So, like I said, it don't really matter what level you're playing at. Everybody can bring it, and I think you'll learn that if you get this opportunity to play here.
Yeah. How weird is it going to be though this spring with football going on and baseball and softball going on and everything at the same time?
Yeah, it's going to be a busy schedule here at Murray. I know volleyball opened up, softball goes on the road this weekend, football opens up next weekend, we open up. You know, every sport's going on here at Murray just because of everything getting canceled in the fall. And a lot of different pieces moving that way in different directions. So it's definitely going to be busy and excited for all of us to actually get an opportunity to go out and compete. You know, obviously last year, you know, we got shut down early. A lot of sports did. So it's exciting for us athletes to get an opportunity to go back out and compete again. So, yeah, it's going to be a lot of moving pieces, and it's going to be a busy spring for sure.
Yeah. Do you have any goals for this year individually or anything as a team you guys would like to accomplish?
Yeah. You know, first of all, OVC championship, you know, hadn't been done here in quite a few years. So, I think we got the guys, we got the talent to do it this year. You know, it's just all about going out and executing it. It's a tough league. You know, we got Jacksonville State, Belmont, you got EKU, you know, you got the Moorheads, you know, but you got those guys. But in reality, we're just as good or better than them guys. And I think we have the team and we have the staff to go all the way. And then after that, that's bonus baseball. You know, if you can get a bid to play in the College World Series, make a regional, that's just bonus baseball, and just go out and make the best opportunity you can of it, for sure.
Shane, appreciate you coming on the show this morning. Just one more question. How's your golf game looking these days?
I hadn't touched a club probably since last July. So
I'm up for a game then.
you would probably beat me. I'd be lucky if I cracked 110 today.
We'll have to get back out there one of these days.
Double bogey golf would be good for me.
Well, good luck to you guys. I hope the season gets going next week like it's supposed to, and looking forward for a big year from you and the Racers.
All right, appreciate it, Todd. You stay safe.
You too, Shane.
All right, thank you.
That is Shane Burns, former Caldwell County Tiger, now Murray State University pitcher, maybe looking to be the ace on the staff for the starters this year, so we'll be keeping an eye on him. Need to get to a break here on the show. We'll be back with more, though. Lady Tiger softball coach Seath Butts is in the studio with us, and we'll continue here on the Sideline Report after this on 1580 103.3 WPKY.
Willow Pond in Eddyville is famous for their delicious fish, white beans, and hush puppies. Something you may not know about Willow Pond is that you can purchase all your favorites in large quantities to feed any number of people. This is perfect for family gatherings, the holidays, and corporate events or parties. Let Willow Pond make your life easier and your event delicious. Just contact Willow Pond of Eddyville for details and pricing. Willow Pond of Eddyville.
Get into shape and feel good at Trilogy Performance Sports. Trilogy offers a wide range of family-friendly classes as well as personal training, yoga, gymnastics, sports training, cardio, and weightlifting. Trilogy has something for everyone. Trilogy now offers an app with online workouts, live classes, nutrition tracking, and more. Search Trilogy Performance Sports in your app store. Use sign-up code 1824. For app info and more, follow them on Facebook.
Life is filled with moments. Moments we share with those we love, worry about, and strive to protect the most. At Woodman Life, we provide life insurance and retirement products to help protect you and your family so that you can enjoy all the moments to come.
This is Josh Ray, your local Woodman Life agent. Come see us at 1009 West Main Street or give us a call at 365-6111.
Certain eligibility and age restrictions apply. Woodman of the World Life Insurance Society, Omaha, Nebraska.
Everybody loves to feel special. Treasures Remembered Florist and Greenhouse can help you send some love this Valentine's Day. Call in your orders today for roses, bouquets, stuffed animals, and balloons. We have lots of items in the showroom perfect for easy pickup or delivery in town. Treasures Remembered Florist and Greenhouse, 600 West Locust Street in Princeton. Call 270-365-2556. Serving the floral needs of Caldwell County for 100 years. Treasures Remembered Florist and Greenhouse.
Winter's creeping our way. It's time to button up your car, truck, and SUV with a pre-winter inspection from Trice Hughes' service department. They'll do a multi-point inspection of your vehicle, including checking your antifreeze, wiper blades, battery, and more. Time to get ready for Old Man Winter with Trice Hughes.
Trice Hughes is here for you and any questions you may have about your vehicle. Buy your next vehicle from the home team. Find them on Highway 91 North, Princeton, or at TriceHughes.com.
1580-103.3 WPKY. Update on our closings and road conditions this morning. Baptist Health Physical Therapy is closed today. Catstail Used Bookstore is going to be closed. Caldwell County Extension Office is closed today. Adams Breezy Hill Farm is closed for lunch today. You can stay tuned for an update on dinner. As far as Gather on Main, they're offering some ways to warm up for our emergency road crews and emergency officials that have to be out, our frontline workers this morning. So thank you to them. PAC Senior Centers, Administrative and Community Services and offices will be closed today. It looks like Service Plus will be closed today. Tiger football. No school means no lifting. Now, this includes the Friday lifts. If you still have strawberry orders, you can contact Coach Barnes. We need that total number of flats sold ASAP. Please stay off the roads. As far as our county and city updates, of course, in Lyon County, Sheriff Brent White says to please use caution if you get out. They have a non-emergency number, 270-388-0911. If you see something that needs attention, such as debris and trees that may have fallen, of course, those wind gusts are starting to pick up, he says, in Lyon County, to 15 to 20 mile an hour. When that happens, those trees and debris can be falling. Again, non-emergency number in Lyon County, 270-388-0911. Now, in Caldwell County, our judge executive, Larry Curling, has announced that the Caldwell County Courthouse will be closed, as will be the recycling and the Caldwell County shelter. Here's the emergency number, the non-emergency number for Caldwell County to call with debris in the roadway, 270-365-2041. Of course, for a tree or debris in the road in a curve or in a spot that's hidden to motorists until they get right on it. If you see that, please call 911. The Majestic House will be closed today in Princeton. They are also asking that WCA customers in Caldwell Caldwell County. Jeff Sims has let us know that trash pickup in Caldwell County is canceled for today. They will let us know as far as a rescheduled pickup time and day if you're missing your day today. That WCA office is closed today as well in an effort to get their employees and customers and keep them safe. Pinneral District Health Departments will be closed today due to slick road conditions. Vaccination clinics, Caldwell, Trigg counties have been canceled. Those health department officials will be calling you to reschedule your appointments as soon as possible. As well as Bradley Markey with Waste Path has let us know that trash pickup inside Princeton city limits has been postponed for today for the safety of their customers and their employees. They will be announcing later today a rescheduled date and time for your trash pickup. There are updated closings and road updates and weather updates on our website. For all of that, please log on to WPKYonline.com.
Your WPKY Weather Edge Weather Center forecast is brought to you by Brantley Furniture.
From the Weather Edge, this is a special weather advisory.
The high storm warning continues until 6 o'clock tonight for the entire listening area. Our forecast today, 80% chance for wintry mix of precipitation. Today's high temperature up to 33 degrees. Little or no ice accumulation expected during the daytime hours. Little or no sleet accumulation expected either. Cloudy skies tonight, low down to 20. Mostly cloudy on Friday with a high 35. Cloudy Saturday, high only 29 degrees. Once again, ice storm warning in effect until 6 o'clock tonight. 80% chance of wintry mix of precipitation throughout the daytime hours with a high near 33. Right now, we're holding steady at 26 degrees. Mostly cloudy skies around the region this morning.
Trice Hughes wants your vehicle to last as long as possible. It's getting cooler, and that brings on the yellow light on your dash. Tire pressure. When the temperature drops, so does your tire pressure. This can cause the warning. Stop by Trice Hughes, and they'll check your tires and get rid of that stubborn light.
Trice Hughes is here for you and any questions you may have about your vehicle. Buy your next vehicle from the home team. Find them on Highway 91 North, Princeton, or at TriceHughes.com.
Hi, this is Kelly Martin of Pennyroyal Hospice, and we are proud to be a part of the greatest comeback of all time.
This is the Sideline Report on 1580, 103.3 WPKY. Thanks for tuning in this morning. Joining us now in the studio is Lady Tiger softball head coach Seath Butts. And Seath, it doesn't look like softball and baseball weather right now, but you guys have been busy getting ready for the season.
Absolutely. We've been getting together, doing some open workouts, conditioning and whatnot, and so far so good.
How are things going so far for you guys?
When we last spoke, I hadn't got to be with my team yet, if you remember. Got to get with these ladies, and I've got to say they have actually been working pretty hard. Been surprised at a few of them, and I think we're ready to compete.
Now, you guys have some new space in the Butler Building basement now. How's that kind of working out?
We've got nearly 4,000 square feet, 30-foot ceilings. It's really, really nice. They've done some good work on it. We're going to get some turf put in there, and it's going to allow us to really train to be the competitors we need to be.
How many kids do you have working out right now?
Right now, I've got around 10. I'm going to have several coming from basketball, and then I'll have probably a few from middle school as well. So that we're going to probably cap out at about 20 for the roster, so that's pretty good.
Kind of looking like a young team this season?
We're going to have a little bit of mix. I'm going to give everybody an opportunity to compete. We have a couple of seniors that I've been with lately, and they're really showing that they're wanting to compete. So I think we're going to have a little bit of a mix.
How difficult was it putting together a schedule this year? And looks like you guys have kind of a challenging slate of games coming up.
Well, the thing is with me, I'm absolutely every time I schedule, I'm going to schedule as hard as I can because we don't train to beat the worst. We train to beat the best so that we can adjust when we are playing some of the lesser opponents. We've had to schedule twice, actually. Of course, with basketball doing their thing, it pushed us back a couple of weeks. But I was able to get several games scheduled in. I think I'm in the 31-32 game seat right now, and that's the best we could do this year.
First game still Henderson County, the 29th of March.
Absolutely.
Up there, that'll be a big challenge. Henderson County ranked number one by the coaches going into the season, and as always, the second region looks like it has a pretty deep field in softball this year.
It does, and I look forward to do that for, you know, the future. We're going to jump in that mix before too long, but until we get up there in the top, we're going to give them all they want.
Top five teams, according to the coaches, were Henderson County at number one, Lyon County at number two, then Christian County, Madisonville, North Hopkins, and Webster County. And if you followed high school softball in the second region the past several years, that's the same group that's always up there.
Yeah, they continue to reload. And I know a couple of those teams are going to lose several seniors this year, so they'll be somewhat on the rebuilding stage in upcoming years, and we'll be up there ready to knock them off.
Coaches also announced the top five players in the region. Pickle Winkler from Christian County, number one. Callista Collins at Lyon, number two. Serenity Shimwell from Christian County, it's three. A tie with Caitlin Kemp from Henderson County at number three. Sydney Melton at number five. She's from Lyon County, so a good group there. But Allie Felker got some votes from your team, too, for that.
She's going to absolutely open some eyes this year. She has really been putting in the work. I've always known she's capable. This may be a breakout year for her. And look out for the at the end of the season ranking. She may be up there in top five.
How many seniors do you guys have this season?
I believe we have three. And they come with experience. And like I said, Allie's been really leading in our conditioning. I look for her to still continue that role and maybe even a couple others step up.
Yeah, we talked about the scheduling just a little bit there, but with the COVID going on and the season getting pushed back, you said you had to work on it a couple of times before you had it finished?
Yes. The only thing that didn't change was the pre-scheduled district games. About everything else was on the phone, texting, calling, emailing, just can I get you in here? Can we get in there? And it was pretty hectic, but we got it done.
And you guys are going to see district foe Hopkins County Central pretty quick.
Mm-hmm. We get them second week of season.
Madisonville, you have to play them. Mm-hmm. Now, is it going to be like basketball where just the first district game counts, or will both district games count for baseball and softball?
From what I've been told, it's going to be basically the same as basketball.
Just the first game counts. So
which
that
hurts
makes
us.
A big deal.
Yeah. Well, you've got some starters that are currently in basketball, and they're going to be a little bit behind probably, but they're athletes, so they'll be able to compete.
One good thing about this season, you get to host the district tournament.
Yes, it's going to be awesome. We've done a lot of field work in the past year, and really excited to show it off.
Well, that was kind of my next question. How much work have you guys done on the facility, and what's maybe your overall plans for that?
We actually, of course, last year, which it didn't get to show, but we had an all-new infield. We had sod in the outfield. We've done some work on the fences. Future plans are renew the dugouts, brick backstop or block backstop. We'll have sod around all that area, too, and it'll just make it more welcoming for everybody. And it's going to take a little time, but, you know, with time comes greatness.
Well, the unfortunate thing for all the spring sports kids is, you know, they're going into this season, and it's really been 2 years since they've had a chance to compete.
Yes, that's the bad part about it. If you've had, you know, student athletes that have not participated in travel sports, which a lot of them do travel sports, and it's going to be a little bit harder for the ones that do not. So, but I'm going to train them, and so far they've been willing to work to get to that point where they haven't missed a lick.
Well, and I've already told everybody that I'm going to say last season forever, but it's going to be 2 years ago.
Yes.
You know, there was no last season, unfortunately, but good to get out there on the field. The field looks good. You know, everything about the park's looking better, and can't wait for the season to start.
I absolutely can't. What we're doing, we're trying to change culture within the softball world and getting a lot of help from outside entities. And it's the culture is going to change, and we're going to have that attitude, and we're going to carry ourselves with that, and it'll be wonderful.
Well, and the softball program at Caldwell County has quite a bit of tradition and history. You go back and regional championships in 1998, 2000, 2002, state runner-up, as a matter of fact, in 1998 to Owensboro Catholic. So had quite a bit of a run there, and just a couple of seasons ago made it to the regional championship game and lost in extra innings to Christian County. So it's, you know, the ability is there.
You know, it's Coach G, I can talk about him for days. You know, you may not be aware, but he is the number two winningest coach in the state of Kentucky in fast pitch.
Wow.
Coach George Randolph at Owensboro Catholic actually retired and went back for a couple of years.
Yeah.
And passed Coach G in wins. So the program's had a storied history, and I look for that to continue. There's no reason why it shouldn't.
Talking this morning with Seath Butts, who is the new Lady Tigers softball head coach. Need to get to a break here on the show, but we'll be back with more on the Sideline Report right after this here on 1580 103.3 WPKY.
Your WPKY Weather Edge Weather Center forecast is brought to you by Community Medical.
From the Weather Edge, this is a special weather advisory.
The ice storm warning continues until 6 o'clock tonight for the entire listening area. Our forecast today, 80% chance for a wintry mix of precipitation. Today's high temperature up to 33 degrees. Little or no ice accumulation expected during the daytime hours. Little or no sleet accumulation expected either. Cloudy skies tonight, low down to 20. Mostly cloudy on Friday with a high 35. Cloudy Saturday, high only 29 degrees. Once again, ice storm warning in effect until 6 o'clock tonight. 80% chance of a wintry mix of precipitation throughout the daytime hours with a high near 33. Right now, we're holding steady at 26 degrees. Mostly cloudy skies around the region this morning.
Improvements are coming to weekday early mornings. If you're an early riser, you won't be disappointed. Stay tuned to WPKY for the latest. More information is coming soon.
Deer season's right around the corner, so if you happen to bag that big buck with your vehicle, let Trice Hughes' Collision Center go to work for you. Call or stop by for a free estimate.
Great people make up our home team at Trice Hughes. Trice Hughes is here for you and any questions you may have about your vehicle. Buy your next vehicle from the home team. Find them on Highway 91 North, Princeton, or at TriceHughes.com.
Shop local, buy local, save big deals.
It's here. The Loyal Listener Big Deal Store is online and waiting for you to shop and buy gift certificates to local businesses. Go to WPKYonline.com. Click on Loyal Listener Big Deals. Here you'll find dozens and dozens of gift certificates. Some you'll even be able to redeem from your smartphone. Shop and buy 24 hours a day and save a ton of money in the process. Save on oil changes, dining out, haircuts, car washes, and more. Our store never closes. But you better hurry. You never know how long each deal will last.
Welcome back to the Sideline Report here on 1580 103.3 WPKY. Thanks for tuning in this morning. Big thanks to Shane Burns joining us from Murray. Of course, he's starting either his sophomore or junior year at Murray State, depending on how you look at it. All those baseball players got an extra year of eligibility on the college level, so that's good for all the Caldwell County kids to have another year to play in college if they would like to. Joined right now by Seath Butts, Lady Tigers softball coach, and coach, again, going into the season, you guys trying to get in the mix in the 7th District. Madisonville's kind of held that spot for a while now, and seems like it's going to be tough for somebody to try to knock them off.
It's definitely time. We're in the process of preparing to do those things. This team that we're going to have this year is going to be up and down. Of course, it's a change in reins and style change and everything overall. We're still going to look out to compete and beat everyone we can. Madisonville's going to be on the up and downs in the coming years, because from the middle school level till now, I've kind of seen what teams they're going to have out there. I look for us to maybe have a chance to knock some of these guys off.
Well, you mentioned a bit of a style change. What's maybe some of the new things you're going to try to bring to the program?
My style is a little different than most. I play pressure defense and pressure offense. I want the other team to make mistakes and us to be there to capitalize. So I'm going to pressure you to do things that you're probably not comfortable with. On offensive's end, we're going to do the same thing. I'm a gap hitter. I don't like to play short ball sometimes, but I like to hit it in the gaps. There's three people in the outfield. There's a lot of room out there. So if I got kids going 1-for-3 with gap doubles, that's runs. So
we mentioned earlier the tradition and the regional championships going back. The one thing all those teams had was really strong pitching. Mm-hmm. I guess softball is a lot like baseball in that, you know, they always say the three most important things are pitching, pitching, and pitching.
That's 100% true. We've got Alyssa Stallings coming back. She's looking pretty good in conditioning. Biggest thing is if we can hit our spots, it can absolutely help our defense. If I'm pitching low and away and she hits a spot, I'm getting a ground ball. And ground balls to us are outs, because there's no reason we can't catch a ground ball. No reason we can't catch a pop-up. So that's going to be one of the biggest things. We're going to have a couple of others that are going to contribute, and it's going to be a staff job this whole season. So
Well, softball, and mentioning going back to those regional championships, softball has changed a little bit since then. Back then, one pitcher could really dominate not just one game, but almost an entire season. With some of the rules changes, the pitching's not quite as dominant as it was 20 years ago.
Well, I also believe that not only that, but these athletes are training more specific now. There's things out there that we use blast motion. We, you know, Rapsodo. There's all kinds of things. And there are more kids going strictly to hitting lessons. And if you can attack certain places that the ball has to be, then you're going to be quite a bit more successful. So the step up in athletic ability, and they're actually working a little bit harder than what they used to, that's probably what the contribution of that is all about.
Well, going into the season, do you kind of have your lineup made in your mind yet, or are you still kind of looking at kids to maybe win some spots?
I'm thinking we've got a little bit of what we want to do. I'm not a dictatorship by staff. I want to get a feel from every one of my coaches. I even ask the players a little bit what they see. Now, every game, every practice, every position's open. So I want these kids to have it upon them to compete. And, you know, that takes it on to life. If you compete in life, you're going to be successful. And if they can compete at this level and be successful, then it's going to help them overall.
Obviously, the long-term goal is to get back to competing for those regional championships. What would be a good year, though, for you guys this season?
If we're 500 and if we get to 700, and I think we can even with our tough schedule, I think we're going to have some surprise wins to you guys, which I believe we can win every game, which I'm supposed to. But the way we're going to train and the way we're going to coach them up, if we get second in the district, I'd be completely pleased, which I think is very attainable.
Are there any games you guys are just especially looking forward to this year on the schedule?
I'm going to go up against Collins at Lyon County. I've known Jason for a while. Great guy. And Calista, she's a phenomenal lady. I'm interested to go on him and see if I can play, you know, poker with him, see who's got the best poker face.
Well, and unfortunate that last season never got played, because I think Lyon County was going to be right there with the favorites in the region. And I know Caldwell County really thought they were quietly putting together a really good team that could challenge some people and was kind of going to be that dark horse in the region, and we just never got to find any of those things out.
Well, we're in season two of that. I still feel like the dark horse, which is great. Lyon County is going to be very powerful. I mean, they've got a lot of seniors, and they've got some great players. And you could easily put in the top five players, you know, three of their players in the top five in the region, easily.
Yeah, I don't think Conger made the top five, but she's on the others receiving votes list. Kaylin Conger, who's probably going to be their pitcher.
Yeah.
Conger and Collins and Melton, they've already signed to play college softball.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's the good thing about all this is, you know, with our region, even West Kentucky as a whole, there's a lot of kids going to the next level. And that creates a very strong conference, region, however you want to match it up. I wouldn't be surprised that in the next year or two to three that there's going to be a state champion out of West Kentucky, because it's very, very strong.
Well, it will be interesting to see how you guys put the entire team together once you get there. Like you mentioned, it's going to be kind of a tight fit between, you know, basketball got pushed back a little bit, and then softball got pushed back too, but there's a little overlap there, and hopefully once you get all your team together, you can fit all those pieces together.
Yeah, we'll have about, depending on how they do in the tournament, basketball will be about 2 weeks with them when they do show up. And that's, you know, these kids are going to come out, they're going to be in shape for one. And for the most part, I know at least one of them is currently working on softball skills. I don't know about the rest, but I believe they'll be able to jump in and compete. And I don't think we'll miss too much of a league. We'll have 2 weeks with them, and with the way that we angle practice and the way we do our things, I think they can pick up where they've left off from the previous season.
Anything else you'd like to add going into the season?
Just come out and watch us.
Yeah.
It's going to be fun. Watch these kids grow. Watch them compete.
You know, the attendance has been limited for basketball teams and was for the fall sports. Hopefully for the spring sports, we can start to open things back up just a little bit, get outside,
exactly,
get some fresh air, and get back to normal at least a little bit.
Well, they you know, with us being an outdoor entity, we've got so much more space, so our capacity is going to be quite a bit higher. They haven't put out anything towards us, but if you look at the college world, which kicks on today, they're going at certain percentages there, and with the amount of availability of space, your percentages are still going to be pretty high, I believe. So I mean, you can put a couple hundred people at the stadium, and there you go.
Yeah, because nothing is more fun than going to the ballpark and having the high school teams playing on the baseball and softball field, having the youth leagues running on the other fields. There's a lot of people, a lot of ball games going on. You know, the place is hopping. That's the best time to be at the ballpark.
It takes you back to when you was growing up.
Yeah.
You know, that was the best place on earth to be, no matter where you were at.
So let's get back to that point. Let's get back there and have everybody come out and enjoy both teams and have good years for baseball and softball. And you mentioned the youth leagues. I know you guys need for those to be good.
Absolutely.
So that you have more kids. So
yes.
We need all that stuff to be going.
Yes, we do. I'm interested in actually even working with the youth leagues to help out with some of that. I don't know if it's been done before in the past, but I'm definitely open to it because these are kids that are going to be, you know, the face of our programs in the future. And the earlier they learn, the better it's going to be for everyone.
Well, I appreciate you coming in, fighting the snow and the ice and all that stuff this morning and being on the show with us.
Well, I thank you for asking, Todd.
That is Seath Butts, Lady Tiger softball head coach. And again, softball season opening up the end of next month for everybody around the area. I appreciate Shane Burns from Murray State University coming on the show with us earlier. So thanks to him as well. That's going to wrap us up for this edition of the Sideline Report. Thanks for listening here on 1580 103.3 WPKY.
WPKY Princeton. News. I'm Lillian Wu. The number of Americans asking for first-time jobless help continues to fall, but still there were tens of thousands more of them last week than expected. 793,000 versus 757,000 continuing claims fell to an elevated 4.5 million.
In total, you've got across the country about 17.